गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल. गुड
आफ्टरनून मैम.
सो द लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सम पॉवर्टी एलिविएशन प्रोग्राम्स, राइट? कैन यू नेम सम ऑफ देम? सूर्या?
यस मैम.
एनीवन पॉवर्टी एलिविएशन प्रोग्राम?
मैम कैन यू रिपीट द क्वेश्चन?
यस, एनीवन पॉवर्टी एलिविएशन प्रोग्राम. I think after Monday, now only you remembering this portion, right? Children are repeatedly telling you that you have written exams. So don't think that by MCQ you will pass 9th. It's not possible. You have written exam and definitely like something like that. I clearly explained the process in the class. Sorry?
So
Mahatma.
Mahatma Gandhi.
Rural Employment, National Rural Employment,
National Rural Employment
Guarantee Act.
Guarantees Act, which year?
2005.
What does it mean?
Because every person who is educated, educated and don't have job, will get.
How many days of job?
100.
100 days. If the government fail, what government will do?
They will not doing job. They will give free money.
Sorry, they will
give money.
That means if the government fail to provide job, government will give what? Unemployment allowances, not money. It's unemployment allowances. And one more speciality is there. What is it?
1/3
jobs are reserved for women. Children, please revise the portion. This is an important topic. If you are not revising, you will not get it for the exam.
Yes, ma'am.
If you are not revising, you will not get it for the exam because so many projects or programs are there. You will be confused with that. After that, we studied another program. What is it? Why your videos are off? All of you have connectivity issue.
No, ma'am.
Then after that, which program we studied?
Ma'am, Prime Minister Rozgar Yojana. Yojana.
Prime Minister Rozgar Yojana. It was introduced in?
It was introduced in 1993.
What was the aim of that project?
The aim of the program is to create self-employment opportunities.
Among whom?
Among educated and unemployed youth.
Educated and unemployed in?
Youth.
Which area?
Rural.
Rural area.
Rural area. So if you're studying a program, study it very well. Quickly. Anti-poverty programs, it's a very important topic. That way, again and again, repeating the same thing. A National Rural Employment Guarantees Act 2005, 100 days of assured employment. After that, National Food for Work Program. It was introduced in 2004. What is the specialty of National Food for Work Program?
Wages are given as food grains.
Wages are paid as food grains. That's the most important speciality of that program. Then coming to Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana, it is for creating self-employment for educated unemployed in a rural area. Then REGP, Rural Employment Generation Program, and it was launched in 1995 for creating self-employment. Then Swarna Jayanti Gram Swarozgar Yojana. This program also we explained, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
It is launched in 1999. It aims at helping the BPL families to come above the poverty line. For that, they are getting bank credit and government subsidy through self-help groups. That time we explained about self-help groups. Which is an example for a self-help group?
Kudumbasri.
Ma'am, can you say one more time?
Example for a self-help group.
Ma'am, Kudumbasri.
Yes. The next is Pradhan Mantri Gramodaya Yojana. That means the states are giving, given help to provide basic services. These are the main programs we are discussing in this chapter. And one more is there, that is Antyodaya Annapurna Yojana. That is by giving food grains to the elderly people.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Your sound is low, ma'am.
For everyone, my sound is very low.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Next topic is the reason behind the failure of poverty alleviation programs. So many poverty alleviation programs we introduced. What are the reasons for its failures? You have any idea? What may be the reason for the failure of poverty alleviation programs?
Community support, not that.
Need more community support, okay.
Money.
Money is a problem. Then, what may be the reason for the failure of these programs? Even though we introduce so many poverty alleviation programs or employment generation programs, even now poverty is common. What is the reason? First one, it is not properly implemented in India. Even though so many programs we introduced, it is not properly implemented and many programs are only in papers. Okay, the first reason behind the failure of poverty alleviation program. What are the reasons for the failure of poverty alleviation program? The first one is, it is not properly implemented in India. Many of the programs are only in papers. Even though so many programs are introducing, but it is not coming into its proper effect. Many of the programs are only in papers. Second one, there are several schemes for poverty alleviation. We find an overlapping of schemes. So many programs are there for poverty alleviation, and maybe when we are comparing all the programs, we came to the conclusion that it is overlapping of schemes. And another one is corruption, both at the political level and also at the official level, make it ineffective, and the real poor are not benefited from that. The real poor are not benefited from this poverty alleviation program due to corruption. So these are the major reasons for the failure of poverty alleviation program. As you said, you can write the community corporation is less, that is also a reason. We cannot say it is wrong, okay? So what are the major reasons behind the failure of poverty alleviation program? First one is, it is not properly implemented in India. Many programs are only in papers. Second reason, there are several schemes for poverty alleviation and almost all the schemes are overlapping. Then the corruption at the political level and also at the official level make the schemes ineffective. Then, what are the challenges in the way of poverty alleviation? So these are the reasons for the failures of poverty alleviation. Three reasons are there as the failures of poverty alleviation. One is overlapping of programs. Second one, not properly implemented. And the third one is corruption, both at political as well as official levels. Next is, what are the challenges in the way of poverty alleviation in India? First reason, the number of poor people are more in rural areas. So we need village developmental programs. In India, when we are comparing the poverty ratio, we can see that the majority of the poor people are living in rural area than in urban area. So the number of poor people are more in rural areas, and the village development should given important. Then some states are extremely poor. Which are the extremely poor states in India?
Orissa.
Orissa and
Bihar.
Bihar. Bihar and Orissa, like some states, they are extremely poor. So the special development projects should be taken for their development. We need some special developmental projects for them, for the states like extremely poor states like Bihar and Orissa. Then illiteracy and ignorance, that is also a great challenge before the poverty alleviation program, because many of the people are, they don't know the projects or the programs, the government programs that aim for their development. Due to their illiteracy and ignorance, they are not able to get the benefit of such programs. That is also a main reason or a challenge in the way of poverty alleviation in India. So what are the challenges in the way of poverty alleviation in India? First one is, the number of poor are more in rural area. Then some states in India are extremely poor, like Bihar and Orissa. So they need special developmental projects. Then illiteracy and ignorance are the two major challenges in the path of development of villages. Okay. So the last two topics, one is, what are the reasons behind the failure of poverty alleviation program? Reason behind the failure of poverty alleviation programs, and the other is the challenges in the way of poverty alleviation. Challenges means why this poverty alleviation even now a challenge, because majority of the people are living in rural area and we need rural developmental programs. Second one, many states are extremely poor, so they need special attention. Third reason is illiteracy and ignorance. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
That's all about the chapter. The chapter over. So children, you can quickly revise which are the major terms we discussed in this chapter. The chapter begins with the term poverty, the definition for poverty. Poverty means, how to define poverty? It is a situation in which
an individual is unable to fulfill
their
basic necessities
of life. And which are the basic necessities?
Food, water, shelter, clothing,
education, and health. Plus education and health. Now we are considering this as the basic necessities of life. Then, coming to the vulnerable sections of the society, and in the India's poverty situation in India, around 27 crore of the people out of 121 crore, even now the 21 crores of people in India are living in poverty. Then we explained two case studies, right? One is Ram Charan and the other is, what is his name? Lakha Singh. Ram Charan, he's an example for which case? Urban poverty. That is, he is living in urban area. And you remember his story, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then coming to the characteristics of poor people. What are the characteristics of poor people? That is, they are living in huts. They are landless. They don't have enough food, or starvation is a common feature, and many of them are uneducated and unskilled. As a result, lack of employment or unemployment, lack of education facilities, lack of health facilities, and also debt trap. These are the major characteristics of poor. Then that is a definition given by social scientists. According to them, poverty doesn't means or the indicators of poverty are not only income and consumption. Normally we are calculating poverty on the basis of income and consumption, but according to social scientists, we must consider other factors like illiteracy, malnutrition, health care, job opportunities, availability of drinking water, etc. So always remember, the two major indicators of poverty are income and consumption. The when we are comparing poverty, whether a person is rich or poor, we are using the two indicators. One is its income and the other is the consumption. But according to social scientists, it is not only income and consumption. There are other factors like illiteracy, opportunities, etc. Then social exclusion. The term itself, how they answer, they are socially excluded. That means the poor people are living in an area with lack of sanitation and drinking water facilities, or they are living in the outskirts of the society, and the rich people are living in the posh areas. So they are socially excluded. Poverty itself is a cause and effect of this social exclusion. Then vulnerable groups. Who are the more vulnerable groups of poverty?
Widows.
Widows.
Handicapped.
Yes. And also
backward
caste.
MSTNCs.
Yes, that is a backward caste. Widows and handicapped are the more vulnerable groups of poverty. They are more affected by poverty than the other sections in the society. Then a poverty line. How to define poverty line? That is also an important definition. How to define poverty line? No answer from nowhere?
Ma'am, when the income...
The minimum income required for a person to satisfy his basic necessities.
That is the minimum income required for a person to satisfy his basic necessities of life is termed as poverty line. It is a minimum income required. Then a question is there. How to calculate this minimum income? How to estimate poverty? Yes. Based on the food intake, that is in calories. Then plus
shelter and clothing.
A small amount is spending for shelter and clothing. So that is a minimum income we are calculating. Then food intake is calculated as the calories, right? That is converted into money. That is the estimation of poverty. It is a food required for a person calculated in calorie, and then it is converted into equivalent money value. And a minimum amount is also added for shelter and clothing. So all together we are calculating poverty. And our poverty line is considered. We use as which method? It is a monthly per capita expenditure method.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. And what is the calorie requirement in urban area?
2,100.
And what is the calorie needed in rural area?
2,400.
What is this difference? Why this difference?
Because rural area people are doing more physical work.
More manual work. Same way, when coming to the income, what is the minimum income?
1,000 rupees.
Objective type, that may be a question, okay? 1,000 is for which area?
1,000 is for urban area.
And for rural area?
816.
Why that difference? Why urban area need more money?
Because their living expenses are more.
Yes, cost of living is more in urban area. So calories, it is 2,400 calories needed for a person in rural and 100 calorie for the person in urban area. The difference is because the village people are doing more manual works. Then coming to the income, it is only 816 for rural area and 1000 in urban area. If your income is less than 816 or 1000 rupees, you are considered to be poor. And this difference is because the cost of living here more in urban area than in rural area. And this poverty line is fixed on the basis of data collected by which organization? NSSO, National Sample Survey Organization.
Yes, ma'am.
The poverty line is fixed periodically on the basis of the data collected by NSSO, okay, National Sample Survey Organization. According to World Bank, if a person's income is less than $1.90, he is considered to be BPL. Then the poverty trends. Poverty trend is increasing or decreasing trend in India? Is poverty increasing or decreasing?
Decreasing.
It was 45% in 93-94 to 22% in 2011-12. So the overall trend in poverty is decreasing. Then interstate disparities. In India, which are the poorest states?
Bihar and Odisha.
Which are the richest states?
Punjab and Haryana.
Why? What is the reason for their richness? What make them to eliminate poverty, Punjab and Haryana?
Schemes are more effective in Punjab and Haryana.
Which what development?
Agricultural development.
Then what helped Kerala to reduce poverty?
Human resource development.
And what helped Bihar to reduce poverty?
Land reforms.
Then for Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu?
Excellent public distribution.
Yes. Their PDS, public distribution system, helped them to reduce the poverty. So each of the state, different reasons are there, okay? The poverty, Orissa and Bihar are the poorest states of India, and poverty is declining in some of the states like Kerala, Punjab, Jammu, Andhra, Tamil Nadu, Gujarat, West Bengal, etc. And the reason for the Punjab and Haryana to reduce their poverty is their agricultural development. For Kerala, it is its human resource development, and the land reforms contributed to reduce poverty in West Bengal, and the excellent public distribution system is a reason behind reducing poverty in Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. And coming to the world also, the global trend in poverty is also reducing. Many of the states, they are able to help, many of the countries help to reduce their poverty. Then what are the causes of poverty? Colonial exploitation, growth of population, drawbacks of green revolution, economic inequality and indebtedness. These are the some of the main causes for poverty. And next is the government strategies for poverty alleviation. What are the steps taken by the government to eliminate poverty? It included two types of projects. One is the growth-oriented approach and the other is anti-poverty programs. Growth-oriented approach means when a country economy grows, automatically it will create more employment opportunities, and more employment opportunity means it helps to reduce poverty. So that is one way the government adopted, one strategy the government adopted to reduce poverty. And the other is anti-poverty programs or the poverty alleviation programs. It include MGNREGA, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantees Act, National Food for Work Program, then Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana, Rural Employment Generation Program, स्वर्ण जयंती ग्राम स्वरोजगार योजना प्रधानमंत्री ग्रामोदय योजना then even though we introduce so many programs so many approaches still poverty is a great challenge to the economy what are the reasons for the failure of all these programs first reason is all these programs so many programs are there but only a few programs are really properly implemented many of the programs are in papers they didn't implement it properly next reason several schemes are overlapping schemes are there and the third one is corruption is in both level both at political level and also at the officers level corruption is there that is also another important reason for poverty alleviation reason for the failure of poverty alleviation programs then challenges in the way of poverty alleviation what are the challenges in the way of poverty alleviation poor people most of the poor people are living in village area or in rural area so we need village developmental programs then some states are extremely poor so they need special developmental projects then the illiteracy and ignorance that are the two challenges in the path of development of village that is also a major challenge the people are illiterate and ignorant that is also a major challenge for the development of or for eradicating poverty thank you that's all about the chapter so economics over only three chapters are there for the exam the last chapter is deleted okay from your syllabus the last chapter is deleted so no need for studying the last chapter that is population only three chapters are there for the exam from economics completed
thank you
so much bye bye
thank you ma'am